In the last weeks, I have completely replaced Google to do my searches and used something else called Perplexity AI. Hey friends, and welcome back to the channel. In this video, I will show you four features that will make you consider switching to. I will do a walkthrough showing you how I use it to do my research about AI for this channel, but also in my daily life. As always, if you want to keep yourself updated, don't forget to subscribe and give a thumb up to support the channel. Let's start by doing a simple search. Perplexity AI is available at perplexity.ai. You also have an iOS and Android app. The simple search can be found by going to the Home tab. It is pretty simple and is similar to any search engine, but there are a couple of extra cool features. I can see the search box here and there are multiple options under it. The first one is Focus. It allows me to select the sources that I want Perplexity to use. I can ask it to search through the whole internet, or I can ask it to search through academic paper, for example, YouTube or Reddit. The second option that I have is Attach, that allows me to attach PDF files, images, and text into the sources. This is unfortunately limited to a few documents per day in the free version. There is also a Copilot option that we will come back later in this video. So now let's ask your questions about what is MoE in the context of LLM and AI, which was the topic of one of my previous videos. If I click now on this button here or press enter, it automatically starts the search. At the top, I will have my question here, and under that, I have all of the different sources that were used to populate the answer. I can click on View More here, and here I see all of them. I can click on them, and it will open in another tab. Then I have my answer. And finally, I have Related, which is a bunch of questions that are related to my current query. Here, for example, there is one which is, what are the benefits of using MoE in LLMs and AI? So I can click directly here and get the answer to that question as well. This allows to dive deeper into a specific topic. Perplexity AI also keeps a history and the context of the conversation, so it will remember everything that you have been talking about before. On the top right, I can see search images and search videos, which will also show different images and videos related to the topic. I also have the share button at the top right that allows me to share the thread and this conversation to other people. That sounds much better than Google, that would simply show me links that I will then need to go to one by one and do the job myself. But that's not it. Perplexity has three other features that are even better and more complete than that simple search. So stay tuned, it will blow your mind. The next amazing feature is doing a search and enabling Copilot. Unfortunately, you can use Copilot 5 times every 4 hours with the free version, but it allows you to go deeper into your research. And let's imagine that I want to plan my travel to Europe in the summer. The old way of doing it would be to go on Google, type questions and get super generic answers, spending hours and hours refining everything to finally know what to do and where to go. With Perplexity AI, it is so much better. So let's enable Copilot and see what it does. Here, I will ask the following question. I want to travel to Europe in July. Where should I go and what should I do? If I press enter now, it will automatically search and ask me different questions. The first question it will ask is, how long do you plan to stay in Europe? In this case, I wanted to ask me a better question, so I will click on rewrite question at the top right to change the question it asks me. Now it asks me two questions. The first one is which regions I am interested in Europe. And the second one is what activities do I like to do? So here I can say, for example, that I want to do some hiking. So I will say hiking. I will also say music festivals. And I will also say trying new food. Now I can click on send and it will automatically do the research related to these topics. So here it will offer me a bunch of places that I can go hiking in Europe. Then it will tell me about some music festival happening in July. And finally, it will give me some culinary experiences that I can have when I go to Europe. I can also continue asking other questions or continue the conversation, and it will remember everything that has been said before. That feature is pretty sick. To me, this is a massive upgrade from Google search that is really disrupting, but that's not it. There is another cool feature that is called Collection. Now, imagine that you're not solo traveling, but traveling with friends, and you all want to do research for the holiday. Another use case could be at work, if you are researching information about AI and you want to share it with other colleagues. There is a special feature for that, and it is called collection. Now, if I go to library here on the left, I can see all of my different threads and conversation. But what I want to do now is to create a collection. For that, I can click right here on collection, and I can add a title, a description, and an AI prompt. So here I am, I completed everything, and the AI prompt will help you to get even better answers from Perplexity AI. Now I can click on create down here, and here I am, I have my collection on the right. The next step is to add thread into that collection. For that, I just have to click on the plus icon here, and it will automatically ask me which collection I want to add it to. I can select my collection, and now it is added. If I click on my collection here, then I can see that my thread is down there. I can also invite teammates to collaborate with me on that collection by clicking on the invite button here and adding their email address. Then they will be able to also add their own thread into that collection. This is amazing when working with a team or with friends, as you can all contribute and make it an amazing space to share knowledge or prepare a trip, for example. You can also decide to share the link to other people by clicking on the top right share button. The last feature I wanted to show you today is Discover. Discover allows you to see some topic related to your searches and dive deeper into each of them. I found that really interesting if you want to learn new things and follow the latest trend. Here, for example, it talks about the story of a $25 million deepfake call where a finance worker transferred $25 million to fraudster that used deepfake technology. So I can click on it here, and then I have the exact story and what happened. And if I scroll at the bottom, I can see all of the different related questions. For example, if I don't really know what deepfake is and how it works, I can click directly here on how do deepfakes work, and I will directly get the answer to my question. This is really good if you want to dive really deep into a topic and understand it fully. So here we are. What do you think? Is that something you will be using? Let me know in the comments. Also, if you liked the video, you can leave a thumb up and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.